So of course we want to look at a child's age and stage. So where are they versus where would we expect them to be developmentally? So some of these behaviors like throwing frequent tantrums, getting really angry, saying no, or having a hard time following rules or following directions, these are actually pretty common in some form up to about the age of 8. And then after that, you want to look at impairment. How are this child's behaviors getting in the way of what they need to be doing, you know, at school, at home, with friends? You can also use standardized rating scales. So you can use a broadband measure like the Pediatric Symptom Checklist, which is going to give you information about, you know, are there sort of some difficulties around externalizing problems or what we think of as disruptive behavior? You can also use something more focused, like the Vanderbilt rating scales. So these are really helpful because there's a parent rating form, there's also a teacher rating form. So you can get a sense of what symptoms is a child experiencing, both at home and then also in the school setting. Are we noticing some commonalities? Are we noticing differences? How much is a child pushing back against sort of the rules and boundaries in their daily experience? And that can give you really valuable information about whether or not a child is just kind of having a hard time and maybe a little bit more disruptive on average than you would like, or actually moving in the direction of meeting criteria for a disruptive behavior disorder.